Good evening to you, everyone. Adam Smasher 93 back with another episode of Pokemon Soul Silver. When we last left off, we defeated gym leaders Misty and Lieutenant Surge, and we caught Suicune. In this episode, we're going to continue on our gym battles here. And here in Route 7, start off with encounter three new Pokemon in Route 7. Before that, let me talk to this guy. This is my trusted pal, Poliwrath. I wonder if he'll become a frog Pokemon someday. No, it will not. If you still had Poliwhirl, you would have had a chance to make it Politoed. Let's explore this place. Chomp too much. Please don't talk to me now. Food's gonna come out of my mouth. And this is the gym leader, Maylene. She's a gym leader in the Sinnoh region in Veilstone City, for those who haven't played the Sinnoh games. Munch, this is the Eat-a-thon contest. I never dreamed of such a wonderful thing. After a strict diet during training, I can eat like a Hippowdon. The winner eats for free, too. That's just a dream come true. Didn't even know! Who knew she was a big eater? But is there leftovers here? That's an Easter egg in this game! Holy crap! And right here is the Celadon Game Corner. It is the same thing as you would find in the Goldenrod Game Corner. Meanwhile, I'm going to go through the gym. Now I'm taking on the Celadon Gym next. Now, in the Route 7, there are three new Pokemon we can find. The first one is Soul Silver exclusive, and that... Let me see, how many trainers do we have here? Let's traverse through that maze. Alrighty, what was I gonna say? Oh, the first Pokemon I was gonna explain is Persian. Persian! I have heard from many that he was a very good Pokemon in Gen 1. And the reason why I heard he's so good is because of his speed. It's a fast Pokemon. For those who love fast Pokemon, go ahead and pick it up. And then the next two are nighttime only. First I'll explain is Murkrow. Murkrow has a decent attack, special attack, and speed. And this Pokemon served my friend really well in his Pokemon Diamond Let's Play. In case those haven't checked out, check out the DRock 900's channel. Go ahead and look it up on YouTube. You'll see him. And the last Pokemon you can encounter in Route 7, if you didn't pick Cyndaquil or didn't evolve Eevee into Umbreon, is Houndour. Houndour! It's a pretty decent special attacker. Good fire type Pokemon, well, dark fire type. However, it is kind of a glass cannon. Even when you evolve it into a Houndoom, which it gets better in speed and some of the other stats. But still a glass cannon, because give it one good fighting attack, and it's going down. In Celadon City and the routes we're about to go to later on. And I don't... Oh, there it is. There we go. I'm going on the right path. In Celadon City and the three routes we're about to travel through, you'll encounter two poison types. And those two are Grimer and its evolved form, Muk. These two Pokemon are really good attackers, if you ask me. But kinda slow though. So if you want a good attacker, have them on the team, just try, like, it'll be good to you give it some attacks like Revenge or Payback. Because you know how Payback's Revenge is a dish best served cold, right, folks? Anyways, let's fly. See, after this battle, I want to get Typhlosion up front. Give Typhlosion a time to shine. And Gyarados, you are rocking right now. Aw, you missed. Okay. At the game corner, this is the only time you will get to find Porygon. Porygon is a Pokemon. It's a very unique Pokemon. Which, I think its special attack goes up when it evolves. I think its stats change when it evolves. Like, you could evolve, with the upgrade, you evolve it into Porygon 2 through trade. And then through trade again, and with the W's disc, you evolve it to a Porygon Z. Which I heard is a very good Pokemon. Back to getting lost in the maze. Let me get Typhlosion to the front of the party. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna battle her next. Do you think a girl's only gym is rare? I don't know. There was kind of a girl's only gym at the Goldenrod. Which, coincidentally, also has a department store. Anyways, flamethrower time. There's a trainer in Celadon in the Kanto games and its remakes. It says, please don't bring fire or bug types in the gym. And I'm like, excuse me, I can bring in whatever Pokemon I want. Also, are you not against flying types? Because flying types are also an advantage against grass types. Okay, one more battle. I don't think that was enough movement there to go through there. Alright, one more battle here. Time for a flamethrower. Alrighty. I like explained a lot of Pokemon here. I got Parasect. Well, I finally got the info thing working again. When it didn't want to show up. Like, it's the best to show the exact abilities. Okay, two down, one to go. Oh, it looks like she's gonna have a Carnivine up next. But you know what? Let's go. Burn it to the ground. And you can do these Kanto gyms in any order. Although, no matter what order you do it, the 8th gym at Viridian, that cannot be accessed until after you defeat the other 7 gyms. But me, I'm doing it in the order that I would usually do it if I played Red and Blue, or Fire Red and Leaf Green. Anyways, cut that down, cut this down. If you're gonna need a Pokemon that knows cut to get through this gym. Hey, right, let's see. Explosion doesn't have much experience left to level up. You ready, Typhlosion? Oh, hang on. Are you ready, Typhlosion? Just unhappy to have taken a shower? Well, okay, I kinda There you go. Now you're eager for battle. money. Oh, that's so funny. You'll get over it. Hello, lovely weather, isn't it? It's so pleasant. I'm afraid I might doze off. My name is Erica. I am the leader of Celadon Gym. Oh, you're from Johto, you say? How nice. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realize that you wished to challenge me. I know. I have been training myself not only in the Armory Flower Arrangement, but also Pokemon Battle. I shall not lose. Alright, we take on the fourth of the gym leaders. Going up against the grass-type gym leader, Erica. She has four Pokemon. First up is Jumpluff, level 51, grass-flying type, Chlorophyll for the ability. By the way, all four of her Pokemon will have Chlorophyll for the ability, so I won't have to tell them what the ability is. Anyway, moves are Leech Seed, U-Turn, Giga Drain, and Sunny Day. Start this off with a bang. Oh yeah. Alright, her next Pokemon is Tangela. Level 52. Pure Grass type, same ability. Ancient Power, Ring Out, Giga Drain, Sleep Powder. And burn, baby, burn. Aw, yeah. Okay, what do we got up next? Alright, next up is Victory Bell, level 56. Grass Poison type, same ability. Sunny Day, Synthesis, Leaf Storm, Grass Knot. This is one of her two strongest Pokemon. And her other Pokemon will also be level 56. And let's see how Victory Bell fares against this Flamethrower. Alright! I'm just having an easy breeze right now. Hey, Typhlosion leveled up! Her last Pokemon is Blossom! Same level as Victory Bell. Pure Grass type, same ability as the other Pokemon. Citrus Berry for the held item. Sunny Day, Solar Beam, Giga Drain, Synthesis. Let's see. I'm gonna send out Gyarados for this one. Even though he is a water type, he's also flying type, which... Well, grass types only do normal damage against this skip Pokemon. Don't go easy on me. Give me everything you've got. I've been given everything I got. I've just been using Typhlosion. And now, time for a nice fang. Come on. Ah, this might be a challenge. It's not too much. Okay, something tells me I should have used Dragon Dance! Time for my ticket out of here is by Dragon Dancing. Because it makes me stronger and faster than the average Pokemon. Yeah, drain my energy. I'm gonna give you a Dragon Dance powered Ice Fang. Dragon Dance Enhanced. See that? That's what I'm talking about. You get that experience. Looks like I underestimated you. Oh, I concede defeat. You are remarkably strong. I shall give you the Rainbow Badge. And that is the Rainbow Badge. That was a delightful match. I felt inspired. Please, I wish to have this... I wish you to have this TM-19 as a special token. It is Giga Drain. It is a wonderful move that drains the half the damage it inflicts to heal your Pokemon. It is indeed a horrifying move. TM-19, that is indeed Giga Drain. Losing leaves a bitter aftertaste, but knowing that there are strong trainers spurs me to do better. Alright. So how are you feeling, Typhlosion, after that battle? Seems very happy! Okay. remember correctly. Get out through here. Get out through here. Go out through here. Make our way through here. And here we go. How you feeling? Ready to go to Fuchsia? Oh, yes, you are. I guess I didn't mind the showers this time. Don't have time, Gavin. I guess I have time. Good evening, Ethan. It's me, Gavin. Were you awake? Let's battle. I'll be waiting on Route 26. Give me a shout when you're close. Well, I won't be doing that right now. Because I am going to Route 16, 17, and 18. And by the way, those three routes, well, 16 and 17 to be more specific, has one new Pokemon in store for us, and that Pokemon is Slugma. Slugma, it's a defense, more of a defensive Pokemon. And especially when it evolves into a Macargo, which is becomes a fire rock type. Let's go. Okay, a lot has changed here. Go in here, I wonder what's in here. If you cruise down the cycle road, no, nothing here. Well, you got it. Very well. The trendy thing for you to say would be polyphenol. It's a trendy sort of thing to say. Wow, that's kind of useless here. Okay, on the cycle road. Oh, they changed this route a lot here. What can I speak right now? I'll deal with you guys off screen. Okay, I'll deal with you on screen. Alright, time for a speed run. Get Umbreon out of here. Oh crap. Okay, I'll do that. Sorry, guys. Okay, I'll battle you next. Hey, wanna have a speed battle? Well, I wanna get to... Okay, who do I wanna level up next? I'm gonna get Gyarados to the front of the lineup. Good thing I intimidated Weezing here. Come on! What's with you guys exploding on me? I mean, come on, that's just a cheap... Damn it! Well then. I guess I'll go through you too. I need to heal up my Gyarados. Alright, got Eruption. Call it a day. And I'll deal with the rest of you guys off screen. Okay, I'll deal with you on screen. We're fearless highway stars. Okay, just a simple flamethrower just to end it right now. I hope... Now watch this Weezing explode on me. Or poison me. Okay. Got Charmeleon. Won't be a problem for my Gyarados. Okay, get my Pokemon to a Pokemon Center. At least in Gen 4, Pokemon survive being poisoned rather than going down. Alrighty. And now. Alright, Typho, so I'm gonna. What are you doing? Looking around for something, okay. I'm gonna put Umbreon to the front of the lineup. Because this next gym will have poison types, even though my Umbreon's a dark type. Remember this. Umbreon knows psychic, and I'm gonna give it a PP up. Alright, these will have invisible walls. That are truly invisible. Wow, they did a really good job in this one. Because you could see the invisible walls in the first three generations, but this one, you can't see the walls at all. I'm Janine. How'd you know I was real? Let's battle. Or not. Now, remember this. I want to fight all the trainers. Oh, we got Nidoqueen. I'm going to use a psychic attack. Ooh, very good work there, Umbreon. I raised you well. Oh dear, I wanted to win. Well, I'm sorry. But I feel stronger dressing up as Janine. I just want a dark type gym. This is really frustrating. Wahaha! Betcha, I'm Janine. Sure you are. Ooh, Nidoking. Well, let's go. Go down. Oh, you missed! I got another psychic type for psychic attack for you. Man, Umbreon, you are rocking it since you were an rocking the gym since you were an Eevee. It disguises awesome. That's right, I'm a boy. What's wrong with a boy dressed up as Janine? Fooled you, ha ha ha. I am betting the Janine in the middle is the real deal. Alright. I think this would be a safe place for Gyarados to come out. Nah, I'll just keep Umbreon out. Use a bite attack. Ooh, critical hit! How'd I get so lucky? Ah, not too much experience. Oh well. Ivysaur, give me some experience. With a psychic attack. Oh, what? Oh, this might hurt. Yikes. Okay. So that's gonna be going down. I'll be let's see what your next Pokemon is. Okay, Venusaur. I'm liking where this is going. Okay. I'm going to use a Psychic, and I'm going to call that a day. Oh, crap. And Umbreon has had enough of being poisoned. I don't know why Synchronize didn't work. Well, maybe because Venusaur is also part poison type. But anyways, oh, I lost. You're not weak. Is my disguise perfect? The invisible wall. Could you just knock off the crap right now? If I go right... Eh, I'll just get a full restore. Trying to figure out how to get to that other trainer. Alright. Okay, I was gonna say. Sorry about the silence there. I wanted to face one more gym trainer just so I could get some more battle experience with these Pokemon. Okay, I don't need to do that. I was trying to concentrate on the where to go and. Because. I knew from the get- Because I had a feeling the one in the middle was the real Janine. Oh, Vileplume. I'm gonna send out Crobat. Get on out there. Alrighty. Fly! And once again, sorry about the silence. Just need to commentate a little more. Vileplume should be about taken out thanks to a critical hit. Gotta say, the DS graphics are pretty good. I just need to commentate more. And now would be a time to send back out Umbreon. Umbreon, you know what to do. Against an Arbok. Intimidate me. You won't be slower in with special attack when Psychic comes hitting you. Okay. That'll crunch me. Wonder if Umbreon knows Crunch. I don't know, but does know Faint Attack at least. And Umbreon's leveled up to level 60. I had you fooled. It's so much stress and much fun dressing up as Janine. And now, I'm sorry to disappoint you. I'm only joking. I'm the real deal. Janine of Fuchsia City. That's me. Alright, we are facing the fifth gym leader. That is Janine, who is the daughter of Koga, who used to own this, be the gym leader, and now is the gym leader. I can get this information thing to show. Damn it. Hang on a second. Sorry, guys. I'm gonna have to go back to... Screw it. At least I got the IGN to guide me here. Psychic going. Alright. Here we go. Her Crobat is level 47. Poison flying type, inner focus for the ability. Wing attack, screech, confuse rays, supersonic. Why would you need two confusion attacks? You can just have confuse ray. Yeah, it doesn't matter. Next up, is Ariados. Level 47. Bug poison type. Swarm or insomnia for the ability. Swagger, nightshade, poison jab, and pin missile. Okay, she has two Ariadoses. So who knows which one? Doesn't matter. I'll try and get this problem from the other figured out. Wait a sec. How'd you survive my aerial ace? You know what? I don't care. Do your four store thing. I'll just use strength. Very good damage. I'll do it again. Adios, Ariados. Looks like... next up. Venomoth. Level 50. Bug poison type. Shield dust or tinted lens for the ability. Citrus berry for the held item. Psychic, Sludge Bomb, Signal Beam, and Double Team. And hit it with a strength. And it doesn't matter if he uses Double Team, if she uses Double Team again. Because Aerial Ace is going to hit it no matter what. Ugh. That's going to hurt. At least Heracross is still hanging in there. Gonna use Aerial Ace and call it a day. Alright. That out of the way. Next up is Weezing. Level 44 pure poison type. Levitate for the ability. Sludge Bomb, Toxic, Double Hit, Explosion. Alright, time for another Psychic Attack. Ooh, not bad. Don't bomb me with Sludge. Good, at least I didn't get poisoned for the third time. Adios to Weezing, and she's gonna bring out her other Ariados. Who do I want to bring out this time? Alright, Typhlosion, get on out there. How was that shower at the Celadon Gym? Even though you hated it first and then you Didn't mind it. You've got a great battle technique. This should do it. KO. Alright! So strong. Five down, three to go. I see, you have defeated Koga, my father, and a member of the Elite Four to come here. No wonder you're strong. You've definitely won. Here's the Soul Badge. Take it. Your father's gonna be a lot stronger after I get the Kanto Badges. Like, you're so tough, I have a special gift. It's Poison Jab, a powerful poison-type move that may poison its victim. But let me tell you this. It's going to really apply myself to improve my skills. I want to become much better than both my father and you. Well, let me tell you this. Your father's going to end up having Pokemon in the mid-60s. After I get the all 16 badges. Anyways, time we wrap up the episode right here. So, thank you guys for watching. I go to Saffron City. If you guys have ideas for recommended Pokemon for me or future Let's Plays for me, let me know in the comment section below. Until then, I'm AmSmasher93 and I will see you guys in the next episode. We will be continuing our Kanto Gym campaign, starting with the Saffron City Gym. Later!